sure. So I started telling him about, like,
You said, oh, sure, from the beginning? Or
yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, he wanted to know information, so I gave it to him. I mean...
It was immediate. It's funny because on the other end, Chris Bragash, who co-wrote the screenplay with me, we were on the other side of the courtyard going, oh my gosh, look at her. You know, she has this aura about her. She's the one we have to talk to. And so we approached her like we were approaching somebody at a school dance. Yeah. You know? And but yeah, the minute we got over there, there was this immediate, I guess, the enthusiasm that we felt from Maya, really just, it was like that eureka moment where, like, I think we found somebody who's going to help us and be our passport and may even work with this person in terms of, you know, we may cast her, who knows?
So authenticity. You build this rapport with someone who wants to learn more. Mm-hmm. Tell us about how your own experiences and those of people around you shaped what we see in the film.
Well, let's go back a little bit. From the beginning, I told Sean, you know, if I'm going to help you with this project and you're going to do it about this area, then I need for this to be as real as possible. I need for this to be raw. No condom. We're talking about the movie, though. My own experiences, I used to be a sex worker. I did. But my character is very different from me in real life. Because in real life, I'm always like this. I'm never that grimy, I'm sorry. Yeah, I've always been like this, you know? I think the only thing that I can relate to her with is the humor. Because I'm a funny person. You know, I love to see people happy and laughing because I've had such a dark life. So I wanna see happiness. And even though the storyline is so dark, I didn't want a room of, like, crying people, you know? I feel like when you're in situations like that, all you have is humor and to try to really uplift yourself.